The last Sunday of the liturgical year is always the solemnity of Christ the King, and the readings are all apocalyptic, are all hopeful, and they all point to something victorious, something jubilant, something that makes us happy, something that makes us smile. In the first reading from the book of Daniel, Daniel the consummate prophet, he talks about a figure like the Son of Man, and then equates the figure with clouds. And then with clouds come dominion, glory, kingship. At yung pinakapopular na salita sa Pilipinas, forever. Para kay Daniel, may forever. And it's the kingdom that will have no end. In the book of Revelation from the second reading, John talks about a faithful witness, a firstborn from the dead, the ruler of kings, and then he also talks about clouds. Clouds have to do with heaven. Clouds have to do with unearthly, immaterial realities. He talks about the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the glory that is God's forever and ever. In the gospel, it is counterintuitive. The Lord declares the coming of the kingdom and teaches about the kingdom, but he rejects being called the king. Medyo merong cognitive distortion. He talks about the kingdom, but then he doesn't want to be called the king, and he says, "My kingdom does not belong to this world." Let's deal with reality as we know it, as I see it as an educator and a student of human behavior over the past so many decades. We do not exactly love royalty for being royalty. We love the fanfare. So nung namatay si Queen Elizabeth, may nagpuyat, ang dami kong kaibigan na nagpuyat. Sinundan ang balita mula sa United Kingdom, Scotland, England, Wales, and Northern Ireland, sapagkat namatay ang reyna. We love not royalty, we love the fanfare, we love the gowns, and the horses, and the guards with plumes, and feathers, and very high hats, and of course the swords, and the guns, and the color red, blazing red. We Filipinos have a curious way of adoring and admiring people. What do? We domesticate them. So when Pope Francis came here in 2015, we called him Lolo Kiko. When we admire somebody, we domesticate them. Tinatawag nating tita, si Tita Cory, si Tatay Digong, si Boss Manny, si Inday, I won't mention the name, si Pinoy. We domesticate people we admire. When Liam Payne died, we don't know whether he killed himself or whether he fell from the third floor balcony. No one has given the last word yet. A number of Pinays, millennials, made a wake for him. Gumawa, kompleto, daming flowers. May ataol. Ataud in Spanish. Maraming mga condolences. Look at what we do with royalty or the equivalent. When we admire people, we go out of our way. We call them tatay. We call them lolo. We call them tita. We elevate them to glory, to heights never dreamed of. Pati yung mga walang alam, di na, ayaw mag-English sa Senado, all of a sudden, they become honorable and they get millions and millions of followers. Most of us follow, according to Statista, ang pinakatanyag sa Facebook among Filipinos is Marian Rivera. I don't know why. Don't ask me. And the second is Angel Locsin. But there is another row of popular figures in TikTok and another row of popular figures in X. And I don't know the difference. And I do know that there is a difference between the postings of some people in Facebook and their posting in X. what used to be known as Twitter, and their postings on TikTok. One thing I do know about TikTok is they kill so many popular people. RIP, yung mga celebrities. Bakit? Kailangan nila ng likes, ng hits, ng engagement. Kung kaya pinapatay nila ang mga taong tanyag. At fino-forward, ngayon ang mahilig i-forward ay yung mga kanta ni John Ebron Ecal, taga Sorsogon, 12 years old. Ang galing kumanta, ang galing bumirit. We admire them, we domesticate them, and we call them Totoy, Bron, Ecal. Hanapin nyo, pati kayo matutuwa sa kanyang kanta. We love them, but what do we love in them? Do we love their ideas, or do we love our ideals? Yung hinahangaan natin ay sapagkat yun ang gusto natin o sapagkat yun ang tama? Let me give you a few examples. One of my former students, you know, I've been teaching for 48 years, kaya yung mga nag-i-scam sa akin o nag-aating mag-i-scam sa akin, ang laging linya nila ay, Father, estudyante niyo ako sa Kanlubang many years ago. O Father, Knights of the Altar niyo ako sa Mayapa, sa Kalamba. I cannot remember, I've been teaching for 48 years, I've had thousands of students. But then you know very well that they are scammers because a few days after they sent pictures of a child in a hospital at nanghihingi ng pera. At anybody can produce a picture from Google. So what do I know? So we love ideas, we love ideals, but are they the ideals that matter? Are they the ideals of God? Are they the ideals of the kingdom? But we do love people because kahit hindi marunong mag-Ingles, aba honorable. Kahit hindi nag-graduate ng elementary senator. Yung Cassandra Ong, hindi nag-aral, hindi alam kung saan nag-aral, bilyonarya. We love people because of three things: money, comfort, power. Now, let me tell you the story of my former student. Doktor siya. May nagkonsulta sa kanyang ali. At nung magbabayad na, naglabas ng senior citizen ID. Ang sabi ng estudyante ko, hindi po ako kayo senior. Eh, diyan din naman ako papunta eh. Meron siyang fake ID. At isa pa, I hear this from you. I hear this from the people I give seminars to. Ang daming merong PWD, people with disabilities. Eh, sa unang tingin ko, malakas pa sa kalabaw. Pero may PWD. Naglipa na ang PWD. Yan ang ating ideals. Yan ang ating hinahangaan. Yung magaling, matikas, macho, decisive, kahit ang decision ay palpak. Never mind if his or her decision is against the law of God. Pero matigas, matikas, decisive, at madaling lapitan, madaling mabudol, madaling mauto. Money, comfort, and power. These are our ideals. Today, we are given a lesson. Jesus declared the coming of the kingdom, but he did not want to be called king. Jesus preached a kingdom, but Jesus rejected being called a king. My kingdom is not of this world. And what are the ideals of this kingdom? We heard it during the Lord have mercy, the penitential rite. A kingdom of truth. O yung senior citizen ID nyo, talaga ba yun? Totoo yan? Yung PWD ID nyo, yung ba na nakuha nyo lang sa City Hall kasi may kaibigan kayo? It's a kingdom of truth. It's a kingdom of justice. It's a kingdom of life. It's a kingdom of holiness. It's a kingdom of grace. It's a kingdom of love. It's a kingdom of peace. It's not a kingdom of money, power, and comfort. It's not a kingdom of those who are mabilis, maabilidad, at masiba. And that can be you and me. We are belonging to two kingdoms. We are straddling the road between two kingdoms. The kingdom of this earth and the kingdom of this world. Christ chose to be human like us. Christ chose, in God, in His wisdom, decided to be man like us. That means, He values you and me. He loves sinners like me. He loves people selfish and greedy like you and me. He loves the Filipinos where we believe more fake news than real news. We love Filipinos, we love and hate Rendon Labrador, we love and hate Manny Pangilinan or whoever the other Manny, the boxer. And we love them because of their ideas or ideals or our own ideals. Are they belonging to the ideals of the kingdom? You've got to discern. You've got to choose the right people who espouse the real ideals of the kingdom. And a big question for you and me, for me first of all, because I am a sinner like you, what kingdom do you belong to?